Now in Sunrise, more of the same thing. Wind chill advisories in effect, dangerously low wind chills. I'll let you know when we find a warm up.
Plus, students in Minneapolis public schools are starting the week learning from home. Why the cold is just one reason they're doing virtual learning today.
Plus, ending on a high note might not cut it in Minnesota. The big decisions the Vikings have to make after another losing season.
Plus, two deadly viruses crisscrossing the U.S. This morning, our Verify team buries the rumors about Flu Rona.
And a defining career in Hollywood cut short. This morning, we look back on the life of America's dad, Bob Saget. It's Monday, January 10th. Care 11 Sunrise starts now.
6 a.m. Thanks for waking up with us on this frigid day. Sunrisers, check that out. Temperatures right now well below zero here in Golden Valley.
Yeah, pushing minus 20 like we got that fireplace on back there. So cold, thousands of kids are being forced to stay home for school. We have a list of school closings and delays scrolling on the bottom of your screen. Right now, though, let's get the guy for the complete forecast.
Yeah, I mean, pretty straightforward today. Another cold start. You can see your temperatures well below zero, minus 7 in the Twin Cities, minus 24 in Princeton. Princeton, the coldest spot in the metro. You got that cold bubble here. Air temps, again, minus 21 in Bemidji. Grand Rapids, minus 20. Now to how it feels on the skin, on exposed skin. You got minus 24 is the feel-like temp in the Twin Cities. And you got sub-zero, obviously, wind chills scattered all throughout the state this morning, including our southern areas that are usually warmer. Mankato feeling like minus 6. I'll let you know when warmer air filters in, and plus, when we can find our next snow chance, all coming up in the 7-day forecast.
Yeah, it's a cold one, guy. Thanks. 6:02 on this Monday. Look at the roads. We had a crash just cleared seconds ago. 35W southbound at 62 near Richfield near MSP International Airport. Roads looking relatively quiet metro-wide. Again, this just cleared seconds ago. So right now we're sitting accident-free.
All right. Thanks, Alicia. Sunrisers, keep that phone close this morning. The frigid temperatures is keeping thousands of kids home from school today. Many schools either closing down or going virtual this morning.
Yeah, and one of those districts is Minneapolis Public Schools. And Jen, the cold isn't the only thing keeping kids at home.
No, it's not, Gia. The cold is certainly part of it, but the other part, these ongoing bus driver shortages we've been talking about throughout the pandemic. And in the Minneapolis Public School District, it was seemingly made worse over the weekend. The superintendent says they had a number of COVID cases over the weekend that prompted those shortages to be worse than they were last week. The superintendent says that they were able to make this all work with last week's cold. They just can't today. He said that bus transportation today poses too great a safety risk to students. The district says students should get information from their school or teacher on specific start times today. Athletic and school-sponsored activities are also canceled today. We do know of at least one other school canceled because of the cold this morning, or not canceled, I should say, going virtual today because of the cold. And that is, of course, on our website with all those other closures.
All right, thanks, Jenny. You can stay on top of all the weather in your area with the Care 11 weather app. It's free to download from any app store. You can get weather alerts, a personalized forecast, and check live radar anytime. Now to the fight against COVID. This week, two more community testing sites will open their doors. Both Cottage Grove and North Branch are getting sites. Anoka just opened a site, shelling out 800 tests a day. Gia is taking a closer look at the latest COVID numbers. Gia?
That's right, Chris. State health officials are now saying that these numbers of new COVID infections are just a partial picture. They say there's more disease out there than these numbers show because of things like at-home rapid tests. Not all cases are getting reported. Friday, the reported cases, take a look, more than 7,800. These blue bars here, there were also 33 new deaths. Now, the case positivity rate is now at 15.6%. It is a high risk, and we've seen other peaks, like at the end of last year, as you can see, that peak there, and then also the peak at the beginning of this pandemic. And those are the tests coming back positive. MDH says more than 1,400 people are being treated for COVID. 269 people, that's orange-yellow line here, are in the ICU. Now, the state says the hospitals, they've run out of ways to describe what they're undergoing. That crisis, the word crisis doesn't do it anymore.